I'm joined by Lloyd Russell-Moyle, who's the MP for Brighton Kemptown. Lloyd, you've been making the news. What was it like on Friday or Thursday and Friday after your announcement, which I think everyone knows?
Yes. Well, of course, I had planned already. I'd worked with Terence Higgins Trust and a press association in the Mirror beforehand, so they all knew what I was going to say. They had seen my speech. They had done interviews with me. So I was expecting them to lead on it. As soon as I got off the floor of the house, I walked out and two or three journalists came up and said, can we have interviews with you, etc., etc. And at that point, I suddenly realised it was going to be a much bigger thing than even we had thought. And I said to them, you just got to book it through the Labour Party press team, because too many were coming and I couldn't manage it all. And so we didn't do any more press that evening. And the next morning, I got up at 5 a.m. and I had a schedule waiting for me. So a car was picked me up, whips you over to the Today programme to do a new broadcasting house for the BBC. Then you go downstairs and do Victoria Derbyshire. Then you go back to the studios to do ITV studios. And then you go and do Sky News. Then you go and do Channel 4, Channel 5. And luckily, they have next to Parliament in Millbank, all three of the big broadcasters, so BBC, Sky, and then ITN, and ITN does ITV, Channel 4, Channel 5, are all based in the same building. So I spent probably most of the morning and a bit of the afternoon in the same building, but just going up and down, because, of course, you're not scheduled all at the same time. So the BBC want you to do the morning slot and then an afternoon slot, and then ITV want you to do a midday slot, and then... So you run up and down, and in between time, I was doing... articles and news stories with journalists, for the Time press. Magazine and The Guardian, things like this.
How did you find it all? Was it, you know, I know you get a bit of this, but perhaps not that much. What was it like? How did you take it?
It was fine, repeating your story over and over again. Sometimes you kind of feel like, oh, goodness, surely everyone's bored of this by now. But actually you realise that once you started getting bored of it, people have only just started listening to the different messages that you're getting out. And, I mean, I was keen to try and get out the message around stigma and reducing that, encourage people to get on, tested and treated, and then encourage the government to start... putting some real resources behind this prevention pill.
We showed the film that you made with the Labour Party over the weekend, and we also showed the film that we made with the Martin Fisher Foundation on stigma. So I won't bother to talk about those things with you, but I know the thing that you're really keenest on getting out to the world is about PrEP. Could you give us, a quick overview of how that should work and how it's currently not working quite so well?
Well, PrEP is a pill that you take once a day, very much like the, kind of female contraceptive pill in that sense. And it stops HIV being able to infect the cells. So if you were to get in contact with it, it would not be able to get into your cells and into your body, and it would die out, and it would stop you contracting HIV.
Just like a vaccine, essentially, you take every day as a pill?
It is effectively, yes, as a pill. And there were some trials of full vaccines, there were some trials where you could take these pills less regularly, kind of a once-monthly thing. Again, all these things are being tried out at the moment, and very similarly to the female contraceptive pill in the sense of where the direction of travel is going. In Scotland, they've just rolled it out completely. In Wales and Northern Ireland, they have done a trial where the numbers are unlimited. So they've said, look, anyone that wants to can come on and try and access this pill. But if you do access it, you will have to fill in some surveys and monitoring for the first 3 years because we want to see how it goes. In England, they chose to do a survey system, just like Wales and Northern Ireland, nothing wrong with that. But they put this arbitrary number of 10,000 on it. And they've done a few things to make this 10,000 number a bit ridiculous. First of all, if you come off the trial, you can't go back on it unless you take a new place up. And if you come off it, no one can take your place. So whilst there's 10,000 places, there's only actually about 9,000, 7,000 people using it because people come off, stop taking it, and then they might take it again later on. So the way it's constructed is problematic. But if we roll back a bit, the only reason we've got this trial is because the National Age Trust took the government to court. So originally, the government refused to even allow it to be on the NHS at all. They said they had no duty to introduce this. And even though the NHS's studies had said that it would save, over the lifetime of the next generation, £1 billion, and they said that it would prevent people from getting HIV. In fact, in most areas where it's been rolled out, you've seen reductions the HIV transmission rate to almost zero. I mean, in Brighton now, we are really talking about by 2025, can we get to zero transmissions at all in Brighton? I mean, and we have a fast-track city, so we're going to try and push this through quicker. But by the NHS putting this arbitrary cap on, which is also capped according to geography.
Yeah.
So Brighton now is fuller than some places in the north that might still have some places left on this trial.
Sure.
And they've also capped it according to who you are. So if you're a gay man, compared to if you are a woman or a, you know, kind of drug user, or if you're a trans person, all those things, you have different levels of caps. So it means that some people could get access to this where others can't.
Sounds like a lot of bureaucracy. What would you like to see, in short? You'd like to see everybody.
My personal view is we should go down the Scottish route.
Yeah.
And everyone that is at risk and needs it should be able to have access to it.
Yes.
Failing that, the Welsh route is perfectly fine, where you allow any number...
Anybody.
But you do say to them, for the first 3 years, we'll be monitoring you a bit more closely. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the trial, bearing in mind this has already gone through medical trial and it's been approved. It's already gone through the NHS cost system and it's been approved.
Yeah.
This trial is only based on some people in the Department of Health worried about the ethics of it.
As far as you're concerned, it's good. It's been medically checked. It should be introduced everywhere, and it's a game changer.
Mm-hmm.
And by early 2020s, HIV could be no longer a threat to anyone.
By 2025, we really could be hitting that target of no more transmissions in this country.
And do you think what you did, I mean, I know you're a modest guy, but do you think what you did on Friday is going to enable that to happen?
Well, I
hope so. A lot will change.
The Secretary of State, or the Minister for Health, Public Health, sorry, said he is listening to this and he will think about making some moves on it. They rang my office then on Friday and said, can we have Lloyd's personal mobile number? We might want to speak to him early next week.
That's good.
That's usually a good sign.
Yeah.
All I'm hoping is really that they'll lift this cap and then try it out properly so that we see as many people can access it. Now, you can access it privately at the moment, and the cost privately, the cheapest costs are about £20 at the moment per month. Mm. We're not talking about huge amounts of money.
Sure.
The most expensive is about £100 per month. You can buy it online, but you can buy it online via the Terence Higgins Trust. Will have done the test to make sure they're decent.
What's your advice to people watching this programme and who want to access it? What's the best way for them to get it?
If you think you are at risk, or if you are, if you, for peace of mind, would like this, you can go to iwantprepnow.com.
Okay.
I think .com.co.uk. Google is your friend. Search it.
Yep.
And it's a website that is supported by the Terence Higgins Trust, and all the medication has been tested by the NHS to make sure that it is kosher, for want of a better word.
Great. Thank you very much, Lloyd.